So, put very simply, an interconnection charge is a charge that is mandated by tariff regulations in India, which a telco has to pay another telco if a voice call or if a call originating on their network terminates on the other network. So if I am on Reliance and Nikhil is on Airtel, if I place a call to him, apart from whatever I am charged by Reliance, Reliance has to pay Airtel, say, 5 paisa per minute, and that is an amount they have to pay. Even by way of a mutual agreement, they cannot decide that they will not pay this. The government mandates that this IUC must be paid. Incidentally, there is a consultation paper out right now, which is trying to, which makes the point that perhaps this IUC needs to come down, or perhaps even be done away with. Also, because of the fact that you now have next-generation networks that operate only on IP. And another unresolved issue is the issue of termination charge if you have a VoIP to PSTN call. But taking into account all of this, what prevents a telco from doing, the hypothetical.
Money? Money, I guess. They
No,
make
no.
more money and.
One is the license issue, yeah. The basic is the license issue. You are not allowed to connect to the PSTN and PLM and the VoIP calls.
No, but.
So I'm saying that this is a telco with an access services license,
Okay.
and that is permitted
They
for
can
them.
do.
Yeah, that is permitted for
But
them.
just to give.
I may be wrong. We have to be alive to the realities in India where most people are using normal phones, data connectivity is very difficult, and so a person logging on to a network and then pressing an app button just to save something, he'll rather save time.
Sure. Yeah, so again, I'm not saying that people should do that. I'm just saying that kind of helps you converge and arrive at the actual issues
So
that.
let me just give a little bit of more background on the interconnection charges, and Rajesh has more experience in this than me, so maybe he can correct me if I'm wrong. But there used to be charges for incoming calls, and we moved to a regime where the calling party pays and incoming is free. So to compensate the operator that is receiving the call for the revenue loss from incoming calls, they instituted these interconnection charges so that some part of the revenue made by the operator whose customers made a call goes to the operator that is receiving the call. So that is essentially the background of that.
So the point of interconnect is actually a little bit more complicated than I think we are talking at a very, very high level. So there are two kinds of players, two kinds of points, which is should VoIP players be licensed or not? Now, if they are not licensed, I'm imagining how they would go about interconnecting with PSTN. And the most likely scenario is they are going to take resources from an existing telecom provider, and then they will now switch from IP to PSTN over that. Now, to take these resources from the operator, naturally, it'll cost money both in terms of rental, in terms of the outbound call charges, et cetera, which fundamentally subsumes any further IUC, MTC, or whatever else that might be beyond that point. So I am getting lines from Airtel. I am giving 30 paisa per minute to Airtel, and after that, they sort of take care of all of that. So I think the point of should there be interconnection charge or termination charge does not even arise if VoIP is thought of as an application and not as access or carriage. The second aspect, so I think in the consultation paper, I think tries fun. I think inherently assumes that there's going to be some amount of licensing that is involved with VoIP. And in that tone, I think the question then really is, how should we now allow Airtel and Vodafone to interconnect over VoIP? That is two licensed players. They are both allowed to provide VoIP. Should I now come in and tell them how much they should charge each other? And here also there is a contradiction or a conundrum because, like you rightly said, the calling party pays regime breaks in the data world. Both the parties pays already. And so the question of the government trying to control termination charge or interconnect charge does not even arise. But so in both these cases, I think I actually don't see the point of why we're even talking about interconnection. I think that's just a moot point.
When we will be terminating the voice on the PLMN or anything, mobile or the landline, the revenue will go to them only. A very small portion will come to ISP or any internet voice provider. So where is the retail minus theory? All over the world, the retail minus theory is there, that one wholesaler is there, one retailer is there. So you have to understand that we are like a retailer only, and they are the wholesaler. We have to pay for the point of interconnection to the party to whom I am connected. there the 8% license fee, the issue of 8% license fee is coming when all this application doesn't have any license fee or service tax, then what for a licensed player should pay the same license fee and service tax?
My name is Deepak Gupta. I'm part of ISPA as well as I run a VOIP business out of Delhi.
So what's your business called?
Sorry?
What's your business
called? Eurus. E-U-R-U-S. Basically, what the gentleman from Lutra was saying, the current licensing regime allows VOIP calls to be made to geographies outside India. The problem we are really discussing is the interconnect of VOIP, of IP and the PSTN within the geography of India. And the problem with the interconnect again is that since the PSTN in India, due to legacy reasons, is on a geographic basis, now where is that interconnect going to happen? I mean, if I, as a Category B ISP, am permitted to only operate in NCR, can I do an interconnect outside the NCR region? So the whole licensing regime is completely mixed up, and you know, this legacy, we've sort of inherited this legacy from the time when calls were charged, for distance, that if you made a call from Bombay to Delhi, it would be charged at so much. If you made a call from Delhi to Meerut, it would be charged at a different price. Now, that regime first has to be dismantled. You know, the whole geographic regime needs to be dismantled before we can even talk of interconnect. We are talking about opening up VOIP to be able to bring in everybody who wants to start a IP interconnect. You know, we're not trying to restrict VOIP to only the telcos, which it is now.
There are only two ways. If you have a voice to a PSTN subscriber connected, either you have termination charges or interconnection charges.
I think right. In 6 months' time, a significant number will sign up for free data.
Right. So that's the first point. The second point is actually PSTN is only now being used for identity verification. Look what happens when you get a WhatsApp account. You put your number, you get an SMS confirming your number, and that's done. And after that, the PSTN, that channel is not used after that. Right? So it's you very cleverly, I think that's going to be the future. There's an existing infrastructure which is used minimally to provide identification. And then after that, it's entirely left. So there's no point of licensing that if all the use of the PSTN network is to verify who you are once and then get off that network entirely. So I don't understand what is the point of an interconnect charge, or any of those charges out there. Because I see increasingly in this world, I mean, let's face it, that PSTN thing is going to go away.
While you're thinking about what the regulation should look like for VOIP, it's important to not put any conditions on your perspective by saying, but how will the telcos manage? Or what is a fair way to balance the current market equilibrium? That's really not, at least from a personal perspective, how I would approach it. And to kind of make the case for what industry should or could look at when figuring out interconnection or termination charges, I think it's useful to think about the environment in which termination charges have existed. To advance a particular public policy imperative, termination charges have been set, reduced, taken down to zero, minimized, etc. Right? So it is in the hands of the regulator to say this is a particular public policy imperative that we're going to follow. For this purpose, there should be no termination charge, or there can be a very minimal termination charge. And these are all options on the table. And I think if the core argument is that VOIP can lead to greater expansion of broadband, bring about amazing cloud telephony, reduce the costs and ease of doing business, it's worth considering whether there is a particular policy imperative we can ask for as industry to say, then does not need to be a charge up until the point where we feel like VOIP is off a similar kind of service as a PSTN. And when a VOIP interconnects to a PSTN, perhaps now is not the time to think about such charges to the extent that certain other policy imperatives can be fulfilled.